10 years ago in France, my first book to be translated into French was Indian Creek Chronicles. And that's a story about when I was 20 years old, I spent a winter alone in a tent in the middle of the Sahuey Bitterroot Wilderness. It was 7 months alone, freezing cold, 2 meters of snow, and I was 20, and it seemed like a cool thing to do. I didn't think about it at all. Just, I'll do that. And 25 years after that, I was asked to once again go into the wilderness to take care of fish eggs, which was what my first job was for. And I wasn't 20 anymore, I was 45. I had 2 boys, a wife. My boys were 6 years old and 9 years old. And at first I thought I could take them with me. And then my wife and the Forest Service said, no way, where you're going is the biggest population of grizzly bears in the country. And they'll just be out of hibernation and hungry, and you can't take your boys. And that's what my wife told me, but she was fine with me going. And so I went in for a month in the spring to the Bob Marshall Wilderness and spent a month alone again. I wasn't 20. I wasn't footloose like I had been for the first story, but I thought that this would be another story, and that's the new book, The Names of the Stars. At first, I thought it would just be an adventure story, going out to the wilderness again, playing, being careful about bears, and it wound up becoming much more a story of what makes me do this. Why would I leave my family to be alone in the wilderness for a month? And so I don't realize what I'm doing when I'm doing it. It takes years later to start putting it together. More question of mortality came into the whole book. You know, how long do we have? What do you make of the time you have? And so it's from Indian Creek, a wild young man, 20 years old, not giving a thought about anything, to a 45-year-old looking at his whole life and what's affected me through that life. For me, I never studied writing. I had a wildlife biology degree. I was traveling. I was in Samoa, and I was stuck there for a week, and I bought a book to kill some time, and it was Ernest Hemingway's Nick Adams stories. And I read in the story, The Big Two-Hearted River, there was a sentence that said, Nick liked to open cans. And I thought, wow, so do I. I love taking out my little knife. And with those 5 words, Hemingway had put me in the story. He made me Nick. And I thought, I can write Nick like to open cans. And that really was my inspiration to think, this is something I would like to do. I would like to try to put other people into a story with simple language, seemingly simple. So for me, and a lot of people I know, those, you know, Hemingway, Steinbeck, Mark Twain was a big influence for me. And I think they continue to be for a lot of people. And for me, the wide open spaces, it's where I live, it's what I know, and what I'm always drawn back to in life and in writing.